Hello friends, I am again with the chapter 8, that is rural livelihood. Here I am going to discuss about the people in Kalapattu village. So here one person, she is a woman, here given Thulasi. All of us here work on Ramalingam's land. He was 20 acres of paddy fields in Kalapattu. Even before I was married, I used to work on paddy fields in my parental village. I worked for 8:30 in the morning till 4:30 in the evening. Karuthamma, Ramalingam's wife, supervises us. So here Ramalinga was a landowner. Here is a landowner. In which land Thulasi works. Usually she works very hard from morning 8:30 to evening 4:30 p.m. Here, this is one of the few times in year that I find regular work. Now I am transplanting the paddy. When the plants have grown a bit, Ramalinga will call us again weeding and then finally once again for harvesting. So Thulasi work during the growing of the paddy, harvesting, weeding during the paddy grown season. When I was young, I could do this work with no difficulty. Thulasi told that is telling that when she was young, she doesn't have any difficulty in doing such words, but now as I grow older, I found bending for long hours with my feet in water very painful. Ramalingam pays rupees 40 per day. This is a little less than what laborers get in my home village, but I come here because I can depend on him to call me whenever there is work. Unlike others, he does not go looking for cheaper labors from other villages. My husband Raman is also a laborer. So Thulasi's husband is also a laborer. We don't own any land. So they don't have any own land. During this time of year, he sprays pesticides. When there is no work on the farm, he finds work outside. Either loading sand from the river or stone from the quarry nearby. This is sent by truck to be used in nearby towns to make houses. Apart from working on the land, I do all tasks at home. I cook food for my family, clean the house and wash clothes. I go with other women to nearby forest to collect firewood. About 1 kilometer away, we have a village borewell from where I fetch water. My husband helps in getting materials such as groceries for house. So Thulasi do two types of work, as well as in the field and her domestic household works. So she has to spend much more time and labor to do her work. And during agricultural season, though agriculture is a seasonal work, Thulasi's husband and their husband get work during the harvesting time, and other time he is bound to migrate and go distant places or nearby villages for searching of other works like loading sand and quarry nearby stands from the river or stones which are required for construction of houses. Our school going daughters, Thulasi have daughters, are joy for our lives. Last year one of them fell ill and had to be taken to hospital in town. We had to sell our cow to pay back the money we borrowed from Ramalingam for her treatment. So they have to borrow money for the child's health. So they sell that cow also. So it shows that Thulasi's economic condition is not good. As you saw in Tulasi's story, poor families in rural areas often spend a lot of time every day collecting firewood, getting water, grazing their cattle, even though they do not earn any money from these activities. They have to do for the household. The family needs to spend time doing this as they are not able to survive in the little money they earn. Nearly two-fifths of all rural families are agricultural laborers in our country. There are some who have small plots of land, while others like Tulasi are landless. So here most of the laborers and farmers like Tulasi, they don't have own land, and despite hard work all the day, they don't get enough money to meet their basic needs. Not being able to earn money throughout the year forces people in many rural areas to travel long distance in search of work. This travel or migration takes place during particular season. So after harvesting season, there is an unemployment problem seen in villages or rural areas. In that time, many people migrate to distant places in search of livelihood. So this is the story of the poor woman Tulasi. Thank you friends for watching. In my next video, we will discuss about another person, that is Sikar. Bye.